Denver 7 On Demand is brought to you by Ferguson and BAC Appliance Center, the best in bath, kitchen, and lighting for your home.
I'm Nicole Brady with the latest from Denver 7. In southern Colorado, deputies racing to a call were involved in a crash that killed one of those deputies and two other people. This happened around 8 last night on Highway 12 near Valdez in far southern Colorado. The State Patrol says Los Animas County deputies were headed to a domestic call when two of their cruisers and a third car crashed. A child and an adult in that car were killed. Two other deputies were injured but should be okay. Troopers have not identified any of the victims. Tonight, the Woodland Park community will come together to hold a candlelight vigil for Kelsey Barrett. She is the 29-year-old mother who's been missing since Thanksgiving. Organizers of tonight's vigil want to show love, support, and hope for Kelsey and her loved ones. It's at Memorial Park in Woodland Park tonight at 6. Meanwhile, an attorney for Kelsey's fiance says he's cooperating, allowing investigators to go through his phone and collect DNA samples. ABC News tried to talk to Patrick Frazee on Tuesday, but he wouldn't answer any questions. Frazee is the last known person to see or hear from Kelsey. She dropped off their daughter with him on Thanksgiving morning, and then he got a text from her 3 days later. Today marks 5 years since a deadly shooting at Arapahoe High School in Centennial. All students at the school are encouraged to wear purple today. That was the favorite color of 17-year-old Claire Davis. She was shot in the head and died later in the hospital. An 18-year-old student was the gunman. He took his own life. A Contact 7 consumer alert now about a new scam going around that may seem legitimate at first. That's because the caller claims to be a police officer. And Boulder police say the scammer is using a real Boulder officer's name. Two people have come forward saying they got this call.
Yes, this is my name is Sergeant David Sprague. I'm with the Boulder Police Department. Ma'am, we've been trying to reach you for the past few days. You need to make contact back with me as soon as possible. We have an issue we must discuss.
The caller goes on to give a phone number and an extension. So far, two people have alerted Boulder police that they've gotten the call. The first person realized the number they were given wasn't connected with the police department and alerted police that it was a scam. Unfortunately, though, the second person took the bait. We're told there's a warrant out for their arrest, and that person ended up being scammed out of $2,000. Tomorrow, RTD has to submit a plan to the Federal Railroad Administration explaining how it plans to fix ongoing problems with those crossing gates along the A line. Despite the Fed's threats to shut down the train to the plane, RTD is still adding more trains to the route. We tried to talk to RTD about that decision. The agency said they've had a lot of interest in that route. This morning, the company at the center of the Colorado Convention Center bidding scandal is owning up to it. This is an update to a story we brought you yesterday. Trammell Crow says it's fired one of its employees for reportedly leaking information to a contractor bidding on the process. The Denver District Attorney says she's still considering charges against that employee, and the city is considering legal action to recover money it already paid to Trammell Crow. Former First Lady Michelle Obama is in Denver today for the latest stop on her tour for her new book, Becoming. She'll be holding a book signing at Tattered Covers Colfax location this afternoon. Tickets for that appearance sold out within about an hour of going on sale. Tonight, Mrs. Obama will take the stage at the Pepsi Center for an intimate conversation moderated by actress Reese Witherspoon. We checked this morning. You can still get tickets, but only through resale now. Prices range from $179 to $730 on the Ticketmaster website. Tonight, the city of Greeley will unveil 3D designs for their skateboard park remodel. We got a sneak peek showing new concrete ramps, obstacles, and some other features. Greeley plans to retrofit one park, replace another park, and build a third park. See the designs and weigh in tonight at the Greeley Recreation Center on 10th Avenue. That meeting starts at 6. The debate over increased park fees continues in Larimer County tonight. A committee will submit recommendations on fees to the County Open Lands Advisory Board. Under the proposed plan, you would have to pay an extra $2 to get into places like Carter Lake, Flatiron Lake, and Horsetooth Reservoir. And for the first time, you would have to pay a fee to visit Devil's Backbone. Several public meetings have been held over the past several months on this. We'll let you know if any decisions are made. And in Jeffco, there are some changes coming to open space. Moving forward, you won't be able to use charcoal grills or have any open flames in open space areas. Gas grills and stoves are still allowed. This comes after multiple fires. The county will also permanently allow most e-bikes on trails. Let's see if it's a good day to get outside and hit the trails today. Lisa has your forecast.
Yeah, a little windy this morning. That was the biggest issue as this cold front rolled through overnight. We picked up more snow in the mountains. That's the view from downtown Frisco. It had at least a couple of inches, in fact, in some areas, a good 4 to 8 inches west of the divide. Here's a look at our highs. Now, we'll see a gusty morning here in town. Skies are clearing out, though, so some sunshine. And by 3 o'clock, we'll be in the low to mid 40s. So it's quite a bit cooler than where we were earlier in the week, but it's right around normal. So this was a pretty weak cold front for us, and it only brought a little light snow across the southern edge of the metro area. Skies are going to clear out even more so, and tomorrow will be at 53 degrees, and it gets pretty nice. Heading into the weekend, Nicole, will be in the upper 50s, close to 60 from Saturday through Monday, and some sunshine in the mountains too. So that drive up to the high country this weekend, weather-wise, shouldn't be a problem.
All right, well, make sure to look up into the night sky tonight, but you're going to have to get out of the bright lights of downtown Denver. The best time to see the annual Geminid meteor shower will be 2 a.m. You can see up to hundreds of green glowing meteors. If you live in a suburban area, you could see 30 to 40 per hour. In a dark, remote area, that goes up to 100 meteors per hour. This morning, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame announced its new inductees. There are seven this year. The Cure, Def Leppard, Janet Jackson, Stevie Nicks, Radiohead, Roxy Music, and The Zombies. Every year, the new inductees are recognized for contributing more than 25 years of musical excellence. And this has been your Denver 7 On Demand update. Thanks for joining us. Check back here later for another update and download the Denver 7 app for breaking news and alerts. I'm Nicole Brady.